Alright, so you want to enable SMTP on your Supabase account. What this is going to allow you is the ability to send multiple emails more than this number that is limited by Supabase by default. So by default, we can send 2 emails every 1 hour, and that's the limit imposed by Supabase. And when we send the mail using the service, but what you can do is come here in the settings, authentication, emails, and enable the SMTP settings. But to do that, you will need your own domain and you need an email service to send the email for you. So to do that, I'm going to show how to do it using resend. So let me open here my domain configuration. And resend. Okay, on the right here, I have my control panel of my domain. So this is going to be different depending on which provider you are using. This mine GoDaddy will be different. Each provider will be a little bit different. So I'm going to do the configuration through mine, but the fields should be similar. And on the left, you can see resend, which is the service for sending emails that we're going to use. So what I did was I just created an account. Now I came here to domains and I'm going to create to add my domain. So I have this domain cloudsign.ie here on my right side on my control panel. And what I want to do is I want to add a subdomain called auth.cloudsign.ie. And you can see here the tip that this is a good having a subdomain to send email, it's a good idea just to protect the domain reputation. So that's what we are trying to do here. And what it means is basically if someone tries to do some sort of attack to your application and send multiple emails, your application, the reputation of the email will not be damaged, or at least it will be damaged, but only one of the subdomains. So if you have one for marketing, one subdomain for authentication, and another subdomain for flows of the application, like, I don't know, sending documents, then if one of the domains get a bad reputation, it will be only one of them. It will not be all of them. And what happens is if it gets a bad reputation, it can get to the spam folder or don't get delivered. So that's the reason why we're going with auth.cloudsign.ie. So I'm gonna add the domain. And now you can see the configuration for the domain here. And what we are gonna do is we're gonna copy this configuration over to here. So I'm gonna copy here. So MX is the mail exchange record. So I'm gonna add that here with auth on the left. Then I'm going to do the same for the txt file. So txts are here on the top. So I'll just make sure that I add auth on the left. And last, we have this other txt. So let me add txt paste here. And send.auth. Okay. And this one is send.auth as well. And this last one is resend domain. All right, so that should be it. Now let me save that. And the next configuration I have to do is one more thing I just forgot here, the txt one here at the bottom. Let me add that. So that's the host and that's the value. All right, so now we finished. Let me save again and done. So mark here that I have added. All right, now everything that we have to do here, it's done. We just need to wait for the verification to finish. And meanwhile, what I'm gonna do is proceed with the setup on Supabase. So one thing we have to do first is create the API key, and you see why we need that in one moment. This will be basically used for For by supabase to authenticate. So I'm going to create here a JPEG. It will be supabase and permissions for access, domains, add. Here we go. So I'll copy that and click done. And that's it. So now what I have to do is just go to my supabase and finish this. So send email will be my contact at auth.supabase.outsign.ie, and send the name will be cloud sign auth. The host is by default smtp.resend, and the port number is the default one. I think that was fine. And what we have to do here is just paste the password here, which is the key that we just copied. And last thing, the username, which is basically the same as the sender email. And save the change. And that's pretty much it. Now that this is saved, we just need to wait for the resend to finish the verification of the domain. And it should be ready to send emails through Supabase, but using resend. So if one last thing you have to do is go back to the configuration that you can find, click in here, and you can increase the rate limit now on the number of emails that can be sent per hour. So for example, let's say initially 20 and save. And that's it. Now, able to do the authentication flow through Supabase, sending the email through resend using our own domain and without rate limits. That was it for today. Thanks, folks.